This video is based on an interview with Dr. Peter A. McCullough, who is a practicing internist, cardiologist, and epidemiologist in Dallas, Texas. He studies the cardiovascular complications of both the viral infection and the injuries developed from COVID vaccines. Far and away, the most common question I get from those who took one of the COVID-19 vaccines is, how do I get this out of my body? The mRNA and adenoviral DNA products were rolled out with no idea of how or when the body would ever break down the genetic code. The synthetic mRNA carried on lipid nanoparticles appears to be resistant to breakdown by human ribonucleases by design, so the product would be long-lasting and produce the protein product of interest for a considerable time period. This would be an advantage for a normal human protein being replaced in a rare genetic deficiency state, alpha-galactosidase in Fabry's disease. However, it is a big problem when the protein is the pathogenic SARS-CoV-2 spike. The adenoviral DNA should be broken down by deoxyribonuclease, however, this has not been exhaustively studied. This leaves dissolution of spike protein as a therapeutic goal for the vaccine injured. With the respiratory infection, spike is processed and activated by cellular proteases including transmembrane serine protein 2, cathepsin, and furin. With vaccination, these systems may be avoided by systemic administration and production of spike protein within cells. As a result, the pathogenesis of vaccine injury syndromes is believed to be driven by accumulation of spike protein in cells, tissues, and organs. Nattokinase is an enzyme produced by fermenting soybeans with the bacteria Bacillus subtilis var. Natto and has been available as an oral supplement. It degrades fibrinogen, factor 7, cytokines, and factor 8 and has been studied for its cardiovascular benefits. Out of all the available therapies I have used in my practice and among all the proposed detoxification agents, I believe nattokinase and related peptides hold the greatest promise for patients at this time. Tanikawa examined the effect of nattokinase on the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2. In the first experiment, they demonstrated that spike was degraded in a time and dose-dependent manner in a cell lysate preparation that could be analogous to a vaccine recipient. The second experiment demonstrated that nattokinase degraded the spike protein in SARS-CoV-2 infected cells. This was reproduced in a similar study done by Oba and colleagues in 2021. Nattokinase is dosed in fibrinolytic units, FU, per gram and can vary according to purity. Kurosawa and colleagues have shown in humans that after a single oral dose of 2000 FU, D-dimer concentrations at 6 and 8 hours, and blood fibrin/fibrinogen degradation products at 4 hours after administration elevated significantly, p < 0.05, respectively. Thus an empiric starting dose could be 2000 FU twice a day. Full pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic studies have not been completed, but several years of market use as an over-the-counter supplement suggests nattokinase is safe, with the main caveat being excessive bleeding and cautions with concurrent antiplatelet and anticoagulant drugs. Based on these findings, nattokinase and similar products such as serapeptase should undergo well-funded, accelerated preclinical and clinical development programs. The issue at hand is the urgency of time, similar to that with SARS-CoV-2 infection and empiric early therapy. It will take up to 20 years to have a fully developed pharmaceutical profile to characterize the safety and efficacy of nattokinase in the treatment of vaccine injury and post-COVID syndromes. Large numbers of people are sick now, and many believe empiric treatment is justified given the sufficiently low risk of side effects and potentially high reward. My recommendation is to discuss this with your doctor or seek a specialist in holistic or naturopathic medicine who is experienced with the safety profile of nattokinase in a range of applications.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more great content in the future.